Just being able to stand on this stage and to lift up the name of Jesus has made all the difference in the world. And I thank God today that 21 years ago, the Lord let us stand on this stage. Little would I have ever imagined what God was getting ready to do. And it's good to be a part of this thing. So good to stand here and declare Jesus to be the way and the truth and the life. And I thank God today. And I thank this group stepping out on faith. They've been faithful down through the years. They've been faithful to this gospel saying. Lester and Awilda now do all the scheduling for the gospel saying. And do you all think they do a good job?
Yeah.
Amen. I do too. They work well with all of the groups. They try their best to accommodate. And listen, when you're working with this many gospel singers, folks, you've got to be careful. Amen. But they do such a great job, and I think they really, really do. They work at it all year long, and they try their best to pray over the groups that they invite to come, that this gospel sing will be the best that it can be for Jesus. Amen. And I appreciate Lester and Wilder. Would you all give them a hand for what they do? Amen. So now I got my points with Lester and Wilder, so I'm good, all right? Are you all about ready to go? All right, folks, listen. Make welcome for the 22nd consecutive year to the Breaks Gospel Sing. Stepping out on faith.
For some songs that we did yesterday, so we're going to go ahead and do those requests and
sing a couple here and get out of the way and kind of get back on schedule here. We thank God for the opportunity. I thank God for all He does in mine and Lester's life. And you may think, you know, that if you're not saved, that Christians don't have problems, but they do. They have problems, but thank God we have somebody that we can take them to. And I thank God.
Gates I now can see as they open wide for me. Swing wide the gates. I'm coming home. Angels sing me a welcome song, and I know it won't be long. Swing wide the gates. When I reach heaven's shore, cares of this life, there'll be no more. Swing wide the gates.
Swing wide the gates.
I'm coming
home.
And all is peace, joy up there, in that land, beauty so rare. Swing wide the gates.
Swing wide the gates.
Amazing grace, one grace, swing wide the gates,
swing wide the
gates. I'm coming
home, I'm coming
home. I bought a goodbye, kept the faith, amazing grace, one grace, swing wide the gates,
swing wide the
gates.
I heard a little story here a while back. There was two men that got shipwrecked on a desert island. And after they realized they were lost in the middle of the sea with no hope of any rescue, one of the guys just went nuts. He started saying, "We're dead. We're going to starve to death. There's no water. There's no food. It's all over." He got hysterical. The other fellow just crawled up underneath a big palm tree, folded his hands behind his head, just leaned back across his feet, comfortable as he could be. And the fellow that was so excited looked at him and said, "What on earth is wrong with you, son? Don't you realize that we're shipwrecked on a desert island? We have no hope. We're going to starve to death. We don't have any water. We're going to die." And the guy said, "I make $100,000 a week." And the guy said, "That don't mean anything. We're shipwrecked on a desert island. You can't go to work. You can't make that $100,000." He said, "No, you don't understand." He said, "I make $100,000 a week, and I pay tithes in my church. My pastor will find me." So, having said that, we're going to do something real religious. I'd like to get five or six brothers that would volunteer to help us to lift an offering today. How many? Four guys. Four of godly men that would volunteer to help. Thank you, Brother Mark. I would like to ask you to do something special for me. Brother Mark is a dear friend of mine. He and his dear companion suffered a great loss just here in the last few weeks. God called their daughter home, and I know that their hearts are broken today. They've been a long time coming to this gospel scene. Would you all do me a favor? And everybody knows the words of prayer. Would you just extend the hand right now of grace toward these two dear people? And let's whisper a prayer together for them. Would you do that with me, Father? In heaven, Lord, we pray strength upon these, our brother and sister. Lord, we pray that you would comfort them, Lord, in their mourning. God, we pray, God, that you would help them, Heavenly Father, undergird them with your great spirit. God, though sometimes, Lord, your ways are so above ours that we can't understand. God, I pray for them today, Lord, that you would comfort them in their time and be with them, Heavenly Father. Keep them, Father, actively engaged in what you're doing in life. We thank you, Lord, for the work that they do. Strengthen them to continue, Father, in the power of the Holy Spirit. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, for those of you who don't know Mark and his companion, they go out into the high schools and grade schools all around the country, and they witness for the Lord Jesus Christ. They're missionaries, full-time for Jesus, do a summer camp, and they're working hard for the Lord. So please lift these folks up in your prayers. I'm going to ask Brother Mark, if he would, to ask a blessing on the altar. Can't do it? Okay, brother. Would you ask a blessing today? All right. Go right ahead.
There is a field slogan here. Okay, speak with me after this, and I've got some information for you. Okay?
I'm going to bless God. You all right?
Almighty God, Heavenly Father, Lord, sitting here and come before you, God. Thank you for praising the Lord for another day, giving us Father. We just thank you, Lord, for the opportunity that you've given us and learn more about you. We just thank you for the ability to praise you and for all your new blessings. We ask, Lord, that you take this offering, Lord, and use it for those who are in your kingdom, Lord. Please guide her, Father, and all we do is say, Jesus, we pray.
choir preacher got up and began to speak his mind. He said, "It's come to my attention we're in the middle of a tater fight." Well, we scratched our heads and we looked around, all the tater did we see. And he began to explain that these taters are you and me. He said, "The old spectator, he's a real good guy. He'll show up for every service. He'll watch him preach and pray and sing, listen to the testimonies. But he's not the kind to step up and help. He'd rather keep his seat. And when it's time to lend a hand, that's a tater you'll never meet." And there's another guy sitting in the pew. He loves to hear his own voice. He's got an opinion on everything, from the weather to the song leader's choice. Oh, commentator, don't quit pointing at him. He'll tell you all that's going on and just exactly who's to blame. Ed. And there's a couple other gals you'll want to avoid. It's best just stay out of their way. Oh, agitator and irritator, those girls will ruin your day. While stir it up, the other spreads it around. They don't stop till everybody's mad. Then up steps old brother dictator. Oh Lord, he's twice as bad. But the moral of this story is plain to see. These taters must be stopped. Cause sitting in amongst the church pews are a bunch of little tater tots. And these tater tots are good and pure, but they learn from what they see. So it's up to all us spectators to be the tater we should be. Now the Bible clearly tells us what kind of tater we should be. Not a hesitator or irritator, but a sweet tater, don't you see? And as our preacher said that night, it's either amen or oh me. If God did an inspection, what kind of tater would you be? Cause God's gonna do an inspection, be the tater you should be. We had a request for Donnie to do one less man, and
I'm gonna have to keep me warm and shelter me from storms. Yes, I am. I'm one blessed man. I've got a wife to hold me tight and pray for me at night. Yes, I am. I'm one blessed man. These are a few of the blessings that I have known. If I had doubts, I could go on and on. I've got children and grandkids. I know it's nothing good that I ever did to be where I am. I'm one blessed man. I've got Jesus in my heart, and I know He won't be part. Yes, I am. I'm one blessed man. These are a few of the blessings that I have known. If I had time, I could go on and on. someone says to you, who's that man, what does he do? You tell him I am. I'm one blessed man. Yes, I am. I'm one blessed man.